Hello friends, welcome back to this channel Industry NX. This session is the continuation of part 1, 2 and 3 videos. If you missed earlier parts, then we strongly recommend you to watch earlier videos before we start part 4 to get better understanding. In earlier videos, we learned real life normal distribution example through computerized example of normal distribution simulation. We also learned variance, mean and standard deviation and empirical rule 68, 95, 99.7, followed with z-score probability. Hope you are able to recall earlier parts before we proceed. Today, let us move to next terminology, that is process capability, which is mainly used by senior leadership in manufacturing industry as they are more familiarized with this term and simple to conclude. CP and CPK are called process capability. Before we start on process capability, you should know few terms. USL, that is upper specification limit, and LSL, that is lower specification limit. In our case, our designer David defined USL as 10.018 and LSL as 9.982. We found sigma for 100,000 batch as 0.006. Therefore, CP can be calculated as per given formula. Hence, CP is equal to 10.018 minus 9.982 divided by 6 sigma, which will result into CP value as 1. Most of the companies keep CP target of minimum 1.33 or above. Hence, lesser variation as compared to 1 CP value. Most of the Japanese companies achieve and sustain CP value more than 2. This means lesser process variation and use of only 50% of total tolerance, which is allowed by the designer. That is why everyone prefers made in Japan products, as it has less manufacturing variation, hence better quality performance as compared to made in China. If CP is more than 2, then it is also called as Six Sigma process. And you must have heard Six Sigma buzzword. Now, almost all manufacturing companies are targeting to achieve Six Sigma quality and driving Six Sigma and lean manufacturing. We'll talk on digital lean manufacturing, that is DLM, in a separate video. CPK needs to be calculated. If process is not centered to normal dimension, even if CP is good, in such cases, CPK needs to be calculated as per given formula. Let us understand percentage of rejection through animation. If process is shifted from center and how it gives impact on the CPK value, watch it carefully and give your comments in the comment section in case you need more details. In order to learn more on Industry 4.0 or data science, do not forget to subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon to get more interesting stuff with simplified methods and practical version.